Ladies and gentlemen, your final match of the evening is going to be Lucas Barbosa versus Kyle Bowe.
Oh, hi, everybody. We're back. So here's the thing. Right now, you're probably tuning in, and you're saying, I want to see the end of the BJJ Fanatics Absolute Grand Prix. Awesome. We'd like to show you that. First out, we have Lucas Hulk Barbosa. Next out, we have Kyle Bang. All right. This is for everything. This is $10,000 in cash money. Or check, whatever you want to say. Myself, Raf Esparza from Verbal Tap Cast and Grappling Hour here with Gordon Ryan. We will be bringing you the play-by-play on the very last match of the evening. Gordon, just real quick thoughts. What are you expecting from this match?
I've talked about it a little bit before. It's interesting to see Kyle staying standing here. I think he respects Lucas's passing. Mm-hmm. I expect Lucas to come out. I see either Kyle sitting to guard eventually or Lucas taking him down. I see Lucas Barbosa having a huge advantage in the positional department as far as positional control and passing, sweeping, guard passing, things like that. I see Kyle with the advantage in submissions. Now, if Kyle feels like he's going to get his guard pass, he just brings everything back inside. He doesn't freak out and expend a bunch of energy. He doesn't turtle and create back exposure. And he brings his hands into his chest and does a good job of re-guarding when the guy goes to move after they're passed and goes to create a submission. Mm-hmm. Now, Lucas, if he passes, if Kyle just shells up, it's going to be very hard for Lucas to expose limbs to actually get into a submission. The depth of knowledge just isn't there to bring Kyle's arms away from his body when he's just trying not to get submitted, and the leg lock knowledge isn't there. If he plays a leg lock game with Kyle, he'll probably get finished or close to finished. Now, the interesting thing is Lucas has a decent north-south strangle. So if he does pass Kyle's guard, and if he does pass Kyle's guard, and Kyle brings his hands into his chest to not get his arms attacked, he could very well leave himself open for a north-south strangle. So that's how I see regulation playing out. Now, in overtime.
Let's hold on overtime for just a second, because I think one of the things that we're already starting to see play is you got a little bit of taste of Barbosa almost passing. You got a little bit of taste of Kyle trying to get that leg to see if he can kind of sweep him out a little bit or just disrupt the base. Now they're both up to standing. This goes back to what you were saying earlier with respecting a little bit of his passing ability.
Yes.
Probably trying to like prolong that a little bit more.
I believe this is actually a smart tactical decision by Kyle. Kyle knows that his best chance of he knows that Lucas is going to be hard to submit, and he knows that the best chance he has of submit or of beating Lucas is in overtime. So right now he's trying to keep it standing to drag some time out, and hopefully if they end up in overtime, the advantage will be in Kyle's favor pretty heavily.
Absolutely. This is interesting because, I mean, Barbosa's looked pretty good in this format, all things considered today.
Yeah, that's the thing is he's definitely a lot more fresh than Kyle, and that makes a big difference. These guys have had, a ton of matches, and Kyle was looking pretty tired in some of those matches, and Lucas has been fresh the whole time.
It's interesting to see, how depleted, though, Kyle did look. There are some background videos. If you guys haven't seen them, go to the BJJ Fanatics group. Joe Gilpin has been doing great interviews, but he looked pretty. This is right after, I think, right before his semifinal match, and it almost looked like he was kind of favoring his arm. I couldn't tell if there was an injury, but I could for sure tell you the man looked tired.
Yes, yeah, he's definitely tired. Whether or not he can muster up the energy to get through this match and possibly a grueling 12-minute overtime, we'll see.
Well, one of the interesting things about overtime, and I know I stopped you before on it, is because apparently in there he was prompted, mind you, to respond specifically to you, but he says that he has the best escapes for EBI overtime.
This is Kyle.
This is Kyle.
I would agree with that. Yes.
And there was a prompt that say he also believes that he has the best control in EBI overtime, and that when prompted and asked about you, he said, "Oh yeah, that would include you as well."
No, I would definitely not agree with that. If I was to compete against Kyle in the ABI overtime, it wouldn't be competitive at all. I would immediately escape and immediately submit him. I would agree that he is the best offensively and defensively from that position in this tournament. If me and Kyle competed, I would submit him in regulation. There wouldn't be an overtime. I would pass his guard and I would submit him. I mean, it's just not even close.
Well, we just wanted to get your response to that. They continue back up and forth trying to see if they can even get an inch on this one, though.
I mean, Kyle doesn't actually believe that. Like, I trained with Kyle 5 years ago when I was 180 pounds and it wasn't competitive. It would be worse now. Like, it wouldn't be close. I mean, it's just...
I mean, I don't know. The only thing that is, you know, with all due respect to journalism and how we do things, I mean, they just asked him, what about you? So I don't know that he was necessarily calling him out. I think he just likes the idea of, like, I don't know, let's see what happens.
I mean, if he wins, I would love to compete against him, but I'm telling you, I'm not the guys in this tournament.
Yes, thank you, audience member. We're waiting for you to come out with your genius suggestion to hit him with the titty twister. Much appreciated. Gordon, is there any interest, though, when, like, you are watching this and say you do have an injury? Is it more difficult to watch it and have that realm of, like, man, I wish I was in there. I wish I was doing
that. Yeah, for sure. But, you know, the smart thing with the EBI overtime, like, if it was, like, one match maybe, or if it was a different rule set, it would have been fine. But, like, mm-hmm. to have someone lock a body triangle on your ribs that are hurt and try to escape, like, full back body triangles is just, over in the course of possibly 5 or 6 matches, it's not the smart thing to do. So.
Well, not only is it not fair to you, it's not fair to audiences who would want to tune in for that, I'm sure.
Of course, yeah. The last thing I want to do, you know, I made mistakes of competing sick or injured before and going out and having lackluster results, so... you know, one thing that I try to do is stay away from that. The first time I went out to compete against Felipe Pena, I was super sick, and ever since then I kind of learned my lesson. If I'm, you know, really injured, or if I'm sick, if I'm not, you know, I'm never 100%. Everyone's always got injuries,
sure,
but
sure.
If I don't feel confident in myself going out to compete, I'll pull out of whatever event I'm supposed to do.
All right. Well, we now see Lucas trying to stand up guard. You have to feel, though, a little bit of this is Kyle hoping that if he can maybe keep him standing up, it gives him a little bit more of an opportunity to kind of dispel that base. But spoiler, Barbosa's base is difficult to disrupt.
Let's see how he deals with this closed guard here. You know, 10th Planet being famous for their the closed guard attacks, or the rubber guard and all that. Let's see how Lucas decides to deal with this. Mm-hmm.
Yep, straight into the underhook to try and isolate that leg, getting caught with some resistance. As Lucas...
Now, really the only way Lucas is ever going to open Kyle Bohm's guard is to stand up to vertical posture and start to... He's not going to open it on his knees, so
no.
We're pretty much in a stalemate here. I mean, yeah. Kyle's having a hard time breaking his posture and going into attacks, and Lucas is having a difficult time standing up.
Why is it that you feel that... Oh, well, no, we got rubber guard control here. Lucas...
If he can bring the elbows inside the shoulders, he's going to go and he slips out.
What is it that you feel that there is? That's interesting. Okay.
You see, this is not a smart move for Lucas, I don't think.
I don't either.
I don't think it's smart for Lucas to play leg locks with Kyle. I think that Kyle has more knowledge from those positions.
Specifically, how comfortable Kyle looked on that.
Yeah. it's going to be tough for Lucas to win in that department. Lucas
Unexpected
is good
for sure.
Yeah, Lucas is good at what he's good at, but once you kind of get outside of that, it kind of gets a little bit hairy.
That's intriguing. Well, I'm gonna put the question about why we get into that positional battle in that guard for another day, as we have both participants stand back up. It looks like it's going to be a little bit more of the same of what we've already been seeing. Wrist control by both, trying to get a little bit of edge either way, neither giving up too much here. It is interesting because I see a little bit more in terms of what Kyle is doing in terms of not quite even like a full defensive wrestling strategy, but I think he's just trying to figure out how to maybe wear him out just a little bit by standing up.
Because
I don't see him trying to really improve any of that position or trying to shoot in. The pummeling isn't even really all that much.
Yeah,
so
it's kind of just to wear the clock down, if I had to guess.
Mm. And I mean, if you're Barbosa, though, you're thinking, I don't necessarily want to go to overtime with somebody like this.
Yeah, I mean, I would agree. I think it's in Lucas's best interest to try to... That's why you have to have good submissions. Mm-hmm. It's not that Lucas doesn't want to submit him in regulation. I just don't know if he has the tools to actually do it. Mm-hmm. I'm actually more excited to see the overtime play out than I am to see the regulation. The regulation, I could have guessed that you have, you know, Lucas playing a positional game and Kyle not being able to submit him. But in the overtime, I'm excited for this one.
Gordon is the guy that's skipping the intro on the Netflix.
Yeah.
And being like, no, I'm good. Just take me to the end. It's fine.
Well, because I mean, I knew.
You have an idea. What
it's going to look like in overtime or in regulation, and that's what it looked like.
There we are.
But in overtime, now this is going to get interesting. You know, this is where I give Kyle the big positional or the big advantage. So we'll see how this plays out. I have. I'm pretty confident Kyle walks away with this win, but we'll see. If Lucas wins, he's going to surprise me.
Was there any surprise? Because earlier in the night, you were coaching Nicky Rodriguez, and then when he did, which, okay, I could expect that. Were you expecting the Valet Tudo shorts underneath?
No. I was hoping he took his full underwear off and everything, too. Like, and then he just... I was hoping he took everything off and then just, like, vaselined himself up before he walked out. People don't realize how much harder it is to control someone with no shirt on.
Yeah.
Like, if you ever train without a rash guard, you know, having no rash guard makes a huge, huge difference.
The grips.
These guys worked their ass off all night. One more round of applause for Kyle and Lucas out there, folks. For time, for temper, here we go.
The grips just become non-existent. Almost important for anybody who does any kind of MMA training to at least have to do that, just because of the real big discrepancy between the two. Well, the good news is he opted not to put his crotch in front of Kyle, I think, for everyone's benefit.
Hey, not yet. This is only the first overtime round. There's still time.
And the crowd is at a full hush as we go. All right. Kyle trying to make the inroads. Lucas trying to scoop him back underneath. Now, not quite a gift, but definitely one where he's gripping on the inside.
This is the most trouble we've seen Kyle
have. Absolutely. Can you talk to me about that wrist control?
From who?
Barbosa over here.
Barbosa's doing a good job. He's doing a good job of keeping his feet together, not creating space for Kyle to step over that hook. But you see, Lucas has short legs. It's difficult, not impossible, but it's more difficult for him to lock a body triangle on someone Kyle's size. So, you know, Kyle's whole strategy is to reach down and peel the hooks off with his hands. But it's going to be difficult to unlock Kyle's
feet. Oh,
get his head to the
compromise
floor.
It right back. Credit to Barbosa for being able to maintain that within transition, though.
Now he's walking out. Now his hips are misaligned, but Lucas is trying to put a strangle in now.
Now he's probably just trying to... I'm hearing gargling just from there, but he is about out.
Woo! And Lucas is a little bit... They're both tired. Lucas got a little bit tired, but Kyle's exhausted. But if I had to guess, I'm going to say... I mean, let's see. Let's see. You know, Kyle had some trouble there. He looks a little bit tired. He might be a little bit spent. But if I had to say, if Kyle can get to a body triangle, it's going to be difficult for Lucas to get out.
They're coming to check on him.
Good news for Kyle is that he's definitely the more tired of the two, and he's getting a little break now. So.
Yeah. We're not really sure exactly what is cut or what is bleeding at this moment, but our team is looking over. Looks like they're trying to nurse it real quick. Though at this point, there's not really much you can do. All right. All right. Kyle's going to get his at-bat now. If he gets a submission here, we're done. If he does not, we continue on to a second round.
Yes, correct.
All right. Everybody's getting into place. It looks like they're getting a nice pep talk. This is my favorite thing ever. It's like we have a long talk period that happens before this.
For every overtime round.
What the hell? We've done this several times tonight, gents.
Okay, now Lucas has trapped Kyle's leg. And now he's got a full body triangle. Okay, now this is gonna be interesting now. He's still got a body triangle.
Ugh.
But Kyle's doing a good job of attacking the neck. So the more Lucas reaches down for the legs with his hands, the more Kyle has to attack the neck. Because if Lucas is using his defensive hands to peel the legs off, then he has no defensive hands to avoid the strangle. So you kind of got to weigh your options there. Are you going to try to peel the legs off, or are you going to use your defensive hands? Now, there's a way to do this effectively where you use one defensive hand to peel the legs off and one defensive hand to defend the strangle, but it's very intricate and it takes a lot of practice to get good at. Now, Lucas is going belly down here. This could lead to an escape.
It looks like he's just trying to carry him up. Like, get to his legs and just try to, like, dump him off, which is not going to be the case with that body triangle still in there.
Yeah, and the body triangle is going to be... I told you, if Lucas gets put in the body triangle, he's going to have a hard time escaping.
Mm.
So, now he's doing a good job, and now he's going to unlock it. Okay, so now...
But at what cost?
The body triangle is unlocked, and Kyle's not trying to strangle him, so... Let's take a look. You know, Lucas has used a lot of energy so far, too. Mm-hmm. Kyle hasn't.
He's mostly just chilling in this position. Referee checking in.
Kyle has to fall back down to his hip now. And there he goes. Now he realigned the center line, and he has a body triangle perfectly aligned. And now he's got a hand across the neck.
Yeah. Which is almost, no, Lucas is going to mostly find his way out of it. Kyle's going to crank the other way.
And he might be.
And he's going to get rescued by time right over
Lucas
here.
Lucas may have got lucky there. So let's see what round two looks like. Okay, so Kyle bombs ahead.
Are you able to do the math in your head when you're in these positions? That's something I always wonder about because...
With ride time?
Yeah, like...
Approximately. If it's 30 seconds or so difference, mm-hmm. No. But if, like, here, it's pretty clear who won. You know, they went all the way to the cap with Kyle on offense and Kyle escaped.
Keep in mind, you were also of the kind that had the never-ending...
Yeah.
overtime, which... You know, so let me get this straight. I just want to make sure I'm clear on it. On the third period of overtime, is that still under the 2 minutes or is that unlimited?
For this one, it's still 2 minutes. They're all 2 minute caps.
Fascinating.
Yeah. And then if.
Wait, what? Well, now this is even worse. Nobody can put back on a rash guard.
Yeah.
That's the most impossible thing. To Kyle's defense, Lucas did take off his rash guard. And I thought that we were of the mindset where you could do the tournament without your rash guard.
Yeah, I think maybe what they made the rule was if you can either go into the match shirtless or with the shirt on, but you can't change it mid-match.
But Lucas did.
Well, that's what I'm saying. After the Lucas match, I think they probably implemented a new rule.
Because now you've already been so sweaty, that you basically have doubled down. Now
because really, what could happen is you can go shirtless for defense and then just go and put your shirt back on for offense, and it would kind of be like a weird thing where it took way too much time. And so I think they put in a new rule where.
Well, you can change your local government laws, friends. That's how you make a difference. Continuing again with this wrist control.
Now, Lucas is making a good adjustment here. Kyle's whole thing is to reach down with his hands and grab Lucas's feet, but he can't peel the hook off because Lucas's feet are crossed.
Yeah.
So this is a smart adjustment by Lucas with the cross feet here.
If somebody has shorter legs.
Yeah. Not even necessarily shorter legs, but just someone who... if someone's peeling your feet and you have locked legs, it's much harder to open the feet to be able to step over that bottom hook.
I see what you're saying. Mostly feels like we're watching someone in a straight jacket try to get it off of them.
Yes.
No.
And, you know, to his credit, Lucas has been pretty sticky here.
Absolutely.
I saw, you know, Kyle had some pretty good escapes.
Yeah.
This is bad for Kyle now, though, because the time's still running.
Yes, that's an important thing that I think it did.
Kyle is in the last BJJ Fanatics tournament and in this tournament. He's had very good escapes, and he's escaped very easily.
Yeah.
Whereas Lucas is kind of riding him out a little bit here. So this is impressive for Lucas. I'm impressed by this.
Even from tonight, there's a drastic improvement just with Lucas and the way he's been doing over time, just from what we've seen in the past 5 hours. So, yes, this marks a much higher degree of difficulty to try and pull us off, especially at the end of the night. So this is where it starts to get interesting, because if Lucas can hold him for the full 2 minutes, it's not the most ideal thing in the world, but it puts him in a much better spot if we're going to a third period.
Yeah. But you have to remember that first escape. So if Lucas if Lucas holds him for 2 minutes, and then Kyle holds Lucas for 2 minutes, Kyle's still up on the scoreboard. So then they go into the third round with Kyle having the advantage.
All right.
You see, but Kyle knows this now. So if Kyle just keeps playing defensively and makes sure he holds Lucas for 2 minutes, then he's gonna win.
Yep. I don't know why he's spinning, but all right, guys, it is coming down to the wire for who is going to win the $10,000. We go.
So Lucas traps that leg to avoid having a body triangle locked,
uh-huh.
but at the same time, it locks his hips in place.
I see what you're saying.
So you see how Kyle can't lock a body triangle, but Lucas can't move his hips to escape the position. So Lucas kind of stalls himself out from here. Now, as soon as he goes to move, you see Kyle immediately locks that body triangle. Now Lucas is attacking Kyle's legs. Kyle should be going for a strangle from here.
Maybe he just feels very confident in his ability to control here.
Yeah, I mean, when you have the double underhooks, it's a very controlling position, but at the same time, Lucas can manage to step over his legs or to separate his legs with his hands. Lucas is trying to do that.
I mean, how much
Achilles lock that would never, ever work on anybody. Oh, but he separates the legs.
Oh. And they figured it out.
And Lucas is out. Oh, so the time is close now. I don't know who's winning. If I had a guess,
I think Kyle is still winning.
I don't know.
It's close.
It's gonna come down to this last round. This is a good finals, man.
The skipping of the Netflix intro was much worth it here. All right, guys.
Lucas is impressing me a little bit with this. I mean, he's not really dangerous at all from the back, but he fouls pretty well. So much easier when you can just submit people, man.
Hey, man.
This would have been all over a long time ago.
Don't leave it in the hands of the judges, is what Dana White says. I famously say, please don't let us go to overtime. Okay, hold on. I swear to God, there's going to be a day where we're doing overtime in instant replay. There's going to be a moment where they're like, whoa, you went before. Here we go. Kyle prying the hands apart. Now you got to wonder if... I think Kyle for a split second saw his out and actually kind of, I think, just put himself back into it.
He's getting close.
Yeah. Lucas is really trying to hold on. Kyle feels his shoulders on the mat. This is going to make a huge difference. He's turning in, and he is now out.
That's a pretty fast escape time from Kyle Boehm.
Oof. All right. Ladies and gents, this is what it all comes down to.
That was pretty good on Kyle Boehm's part, so now it comes down to the wire. Lucas has got to really push to get out of here. Yep. This is gonna be a close match.
This is not the time to be lackadaisical, Lucas. If you're looking to get out, my friend, the minute Kyle gets that opportunity, he's gonna go like a freight train to try and get that body triangle in. And
Lucas has his hands on the foot. That's cheating. You see that? Did you see that?
I did.
That subtle movement there? Lucas started with his hands on the feet. You can't do that. It's not illegal.
I literally just said, we're going to get to instant replay, and that's the reason why he felt it.
But now he's got a triangle locked. Nice try. That's super technical there, trying to lock your hands against someone's hamstring and peel the leg off. Yeah, beautiful. I'm sure that'll work.
Oh, Kyle makes the adjustment. Now starts to flatten him out.
And Kyle Boehm's going to be the winner here. Kyle Boehm wins.
Gets the body triangle back in.
That's it. Match is over. Kyle Boehm wins.
This is the thing I always think is slightly inhumane for you guys, is when we just let it go on, especially now that we've done these 2 minutes.
Yeah, even though the timer is clearly stated that Kyle won. But yeah, that's going to be it.
Yep. Because it always makes me think, like, do we just need to see this come to term? Do we just need to wait for the full 2 minutes here?
No, they're going to call in a second.
I mean, this is Lucas not feeling great in this position, and I could understand why.
I mean, he just
why.
Gave up. Like, he's yeah. not, he didn't... I mean, he just spent all of his energy trying to deadlift his way against... I don't even know what that was. He just locked his hands, like, underneath Kyle's legs and tried to, like, lift as hard as he could, which would never, ever work. I mean, he's... The match is still going. He may as well be trying to escape.
Is he... Well, I mean, he wasn't wrong for trying to lift that. This is reminiscent of Hulk Hogan about to power back up, so who knows. I mean, I'm good with stopping it here. I think there we go. Thank you, everybody.
All right, so Kyle Boehm, BJJ Grand Prix winner. And like I said from the beginning, the 10 Planet guys practice this rule set. They know what's going on a little bit. I know I had Kyle was one of my favorites from the beginning. Just based on the fact that he actually practices this rule set. It's clear he studies the things that we do. He tries to go cross wrist and trap hands. He goes cross wrist in the back. Traps hands. Enters into leg attacks. So, you know, he knows what's going on for this rule set.
Just an exhausted Kyle Boehm making it 2-for-2 now at BJJ Fanatics, though.
Undefeated, yep.
Good for him in the second event that we've hosted here. That is impressive for him to see. I think we're just kind of waiting on him to get presented his trophy and giant oversized check, though they are taking their sweet time on getting that to him.
Yes, they are. All right. Going to be out of here shortly.
Yep. All right. Well, before we sign on out of here, got a few remembrances for you guys. First and foremost, this man over here has a new DVD. You need to get it. It's an instructional that helps you with what?
Helps you crush people. there's that. Open Guard's coming soon, sometime in the next couple months. I'm competing December 7th in Houston, so I'll have a seminar there. Look out for that. December 13th in Las Vegas, I'll have a seminar there. Look out for that. And December 22nd in Portland, look out for that.
And just to remind you guys what those things are, that's Quintet. That's Third Coast grappling against Herber Santos, maybe.
Yep. If Herber shows up, if he can afford to get here.
And Submission Underground with Gabe Gonzaga, which will be a lot of fun. And again, Quintet is coming up there as well. And just to remind you guys, when he's saying that, that means that there are seminars around. You definitely want to come take a seminar from his. I have gone to them. They are quite, quite good.
Tomorrow in Boston, Bernardo Fari at BJJ Academy, 1:30 to 4:30.
And that, my friends, is going to pretty much do it for us. I want to say thank you on behalf of everybody here at BJJ Fanatics. It has been a phenomenal night. Congratulations to Kyle, our big winner, and to all the competitors for all of their time and their efforts today. If you are not following me, do so. You can find me at Grappling Hour on all major social media platforms and at Verbal Tap Cast. I also want to say a big thank you to our crew that is working amazingly over on the side, over here, on the floor, all around. They've been so, so great. Our thanks to Michael Zynga, Todd Schaefer, Joe Gilpin, all of the great people, Bernardo Faria, all the great, great people who have made this happen. On behalf of all of us here, it's been a great day for grappling. Thank you so much for tuning in. And thank this man. Bye, everybody.
Bye, guys.